you can see?
Yes.
Yeah.
I will do a plain écran. I assume it's better.
Okay.
It's okay?
Yes.
It's fine, you can see?
Yes.
Okay. Bonjour à tous. I will switch to English if you allow me, because I will, there is not much time, and I think I will do faster.
That's fine.
So I will talk as the title is given, the quantum universe and dark energy and H0, because H0 is very, very connected to vacuum energy, which in our universe today is just dark energy, but is vacuum energy in general. And we are in I like to say that we are in Marseille by Zoom. The content today here, I just will talk on the part of a standard model of the universe before inflation. I will not talk in all the quantum universe is not exotic universe or exotic physics, but is founded on very well established theories, namely general relativity at the classical level and quantum theory at the quantum level, and with the matter in quantum field theory and so on. And doing that, we need to specify fundamentally the classical, semi-classical, and quantum regimes of gravity and on the vacuum energy of the universe. And particularly today, and I will talk on the connection of the Sitter universe and the harmonic oscillator at the classical level, the harmonic oscillator and the cosmological contact, and even at the quantum level. And from that, I computed, and we are able to extract the quantum discrete levels of the universe, which of course are more important in the early, in the very early, as we'll explain, phases of the universe, and become more and more separated and continue, and given the continuous space-time, as we know in most of what we know today, the classical universe. And so, and doing that, we are able to extract the quantum discrete levels for the vacuum energy, the cosmological equivalent in the sense of the Sitter or quantity de Sitter, the cosmological constant, and the Hubble constant appears too with its quantum discrete level. It's a complete frame, complete in sense that all the observables are connected. And more than that, the quantum algebra of the harmonic oscillators in this context, interpreted in this context, is appears to be the basis at what we know. I did the connection with the a more operatorial and formal quantum space-time. Described, it's very appropriate what is known as the Snyder Young algebra. It was known from the 47, Snyder, then Young, and this algebra, it appears very modern, and to talk in the framework of the quantum, the Sitter space-time. It's very appropriate for that. I did recently a connection, and then the conclusions or the remarks. So Planckian and Transplanckian energies are not exotic, are theoretically allowed, physically motivated too. The universe and its very early stage have all the quantum conditions for such extreme quantum gravitational regimes and energies. The black holes interiors too. The truly quantum gravity domain is not reduced to be fixed at the plan scale, at the fundamental plan scale, which is just fixed energy or the neighborhoods of it, but extend deep beyond, is a whole domain, and so a Planck scale is just the onset of that domain, extend deep beyond the Planckian and what is called super-Planckian or trans-Planckian energies and scales. And quantum theory is more, Lita's basis that quantum theory is more complete. It's not quantum theory is not exotic physics, it's very realistic physics, and is more complete than classical theory, and tell us what, in particular, what value a classical observer should have. The classical quantum or wave particle duality is a robust, is a cornerstone, foundational cornerstone in quantum physics, and is an universal concept. There is very kinds of dualities in physics and different pieces of physics and different also in mathematics, but this, the classical quantum duality is a foundational one. It does not depend of the nature of or number of space-time dimensions, is not attached to a particular symmetry of to compactified dimensions or not, nor particular space-time geometries or topologies, nor another a priori condition. Moreover, the quantum trans-Planckian eras in the fast past universe determine, at least we could have indirect signals and determine the observables in the post-Planckian eras. For instance, inflation observables, which are in the semi-classical, are not at the Planck scale, but near that, 10^-6 of the Planck energy set on grand unification. And then we know today that inflation and CMB is observable, can be tested with the CMB, another large scale tool observations. And the cosmological vacuum energy is vacuum energy drives the inflation, in particular its effective field. And the vacuum, till today, vacuum energy, as we know in the present universe. Namely, the evolution of the universe goes from quantum very early phases, which do not arise with inflation, so very much quantum and very much early, to the semi-classical phases, which is inflation, and then to all the classical phases we know. And doing that is behind is the error of time, which is a fundamental concept, even if it's emergent at the classical or semi-classical level, but determined by the gravitational entropy in whatever regime, which is appear as a fundamental, as a very key concept in connection with the vacuum energy. And this particular of the quantum discrete level of the universe from this, what I am talking is a very recent paper, I mean, it's in May, and you can find in the archives, in particular, our open archives at CINIRES. And this is the continuation, said the production of what is called, what can be called is my last year trilogy. Some of you have heard in this series of atelier or meeting and in other one, and is the concept of, it appears it with the concept of this classical quantum duality in gravity in particular, which is also classical quantum gravity duality with new variables for that. And it allows to simplify, we will see and clarify the problem, the quantum structure of the space-time. It appears then in particular quantum phase of the universe before inflation. And now from that, the quantum discrete levels of this, which naturally as all vacuum quantum energy, we know that there is a quantization. We know also from strings, Minkowski quantized, but these appear also for the universe in its very early phases, and we know. So the standard model of the universe, I will not explain, but this summarized, we know that all we know today, even it's more said, the new ones, dark energy and the inflation, the CMB, do not go beyond inflation, said Planck's case, which are here, and we know inflation quantum fluctuation, but that is semi-classical, because it's quantum field theory in a curved space-time sustained, in which the quantum field are the source of this inflaton, and it's going on. And this is, I mean, just to see that my aim was, and it is, I mean, it's a program, to complete the standard universe and set to go beyond the classical gravity regime, and then to complete this. And doing that, we see that it appears, in fact, in red is the Planck scale, what we can know, I mean, enlarge, complete the quantum eras, and the, which are the pre-Planckian, we can call, or trans-Planckian, and the post-Planckian universe from Planck time, and doing putting everything in the units or in Planck units also simplify, I mean, and allows to see better the connection between quantum and classical, because after all, Planck units, which are used, of course, in particular by theoreticians, in all regimes of physics, but it appears very, very natural for quantum physics at beyond and Planck and beyond the Planck scale. So everything in Planck units here appear much more economic, said that putting megaparts, kilometers, and so on in all. But of course, you do the connection and to make observations and so on. This is not a problem. So you have here, and this is the aim. This is the aim to explore now, and hope this is not an assumption. Hope that this appears. So in doing that also, I mean, I can put all the numbers. You can see we will come. So just to see in a diagram, we can attach all the eras, and in particular for the very, it's extended from the very past to the very extreme past we can talk today, which is an upper bound for the origin of the universe. We cannot reach zero, which because of the uncertainty principle, there is no zero, then is no zero time, but there is a very, very small number, which is our upper bound for the origin, as our present age is a lower bound for the future age of the universe. That's all. So, and then we can the quantum discrete levels now here, and it can be put also attached here, which will be, I mean, after the Planck, it will be more and more continuum and classical, but it's very good to see behind that how that appears. So nature is quantum, that means real and complex laws of nature, as those of quantum physics, and classical behaviors, our behaviors, and all that are limiting cases or situations or approximation of particular cases of that, in particular classical gravity and successful general relativity, which in fact, this study shows also that general relativity is very, very solid, but very near the Planck scale is taking a robust timing with corrections, but it's taking robust. But this is an incomplete because it's not a quantum theory, everybody knows, and must be considered an approximation from a more complex theory. The aim is to complete the theory, not to make exotic assumption. So instead, and the key, so We know all that the old-fashioned quantum gravity and mainly things from that are very useful, but we know all the shortcomings and developments which have been done for many years, and its rich bibliography is, I will not came from that, because instead of starting from gravity, which is a large-scale theory, that is general relativity and quantize it, as we know it has been done, I start from quantum theory, from the quantum theory, which is much close to the Planck scale, of course, and trying to extend it and to reach the Planck domain, and then it's very good. And so we can learn from semi-classical gravity, which appears as a particular case, and all the known the examples we know from Hawking and so on, the wave particle duality extended crossing the Planck scale, which is one of my last work published here, and the classical quantum gravity duality in some sense we can call. So as and one of the consequences of that disappear the classical quantum duality of space-time and of black holes, and new quantum domain not present in classical gravity disappear, and the quantum light cone appears, I mean the analogs of the light cone at the quantum level, from which a classical light cone of relativity appear as a particular cases. So I don't have time to explain how this duality arises, even in any case, in blue, everything in blue is classical gravity and quantum is in red, and the new variables which appears are more complete and contains both, and is not just for whole observables. We can do that because from the length, more complete length, the masses, we can construct the temperatures and all that, which contain the temperatures in the classical and quantum regimes and semi-classical as Hawking temperatures and so on. So, and all that. So the classical universe in blue with all the observables said the gravity magnitude, more important, the length, the masses, the density, temperature, the entropy, and a very early quantum universe with the corresponding quantum ones in red are connected in this way. With in black are the Planck scale magnitudes. If you are talking about length, the quantum length is the Compton length for the universe or for the object you have. What is very important is the mass, the dual mass of the quantum mass, the temperature, the dual temperature of the usual temperature proportional to the mass is it gives you the Hawking temperature, whatever for black holes or for the sitter, and the entropy and so on. And so for this, I was able last year to connect, to compute the quantum, not only the quantum correction for inflation, but in red you see how the factor, quantum factor, given you the complete at least including the quantum phase of inflation in blue, the classical one, as we ever know, and we know. And for the spatial or curvature and tensor, and what appear here is the new ones, which contain this is the precursor, quantum precursors. Is very interesting because as we see now, this quantum factor is precisely the exact summation or resummation of all quantum correction. This is H over HP. The Planck is the 10 minus 6, and this is in a square. So it's very, very few quantum corrections, which have been computed by loops And in fact, this quantum appears and it can be, it contains all the regimes, the quantum one I cannot. And also for dark energy, it's a way to connect the quantum and the classical and semi-classical vacuum energies, which are, so the universe today, I want to stress a property which is not perhaps much stressed or recalled, which that our universe is one property intrinsic, is that essentially empty. And that was by astronomers years ago called voids, but not connected at that time with vacuum. And this is the connection, I mean, the universe is empty, and this is the low value of the cosmological constant of the vacuum energy, I prefer to call vacuum energy. In blue, you have the values of the classical magnitudes. You compute with the variables, I mean, we have here in black are the, and the Planck units, and so the you see in minuscule for the, in, you can put in age, you can put in length, and this is what it gives. Put it here, the H value and so on. This is the factor. And the quantum one, I mean, my dual quantum as I compute from this, it's essentially this one without any other evaluation. And we see that they both are precisely this, this red one is a quantum, which is the value we, you can compute from other particle physics evaluations and so on, which is this huge factor, difference of factor, which are explained. This does not solve the cosmological constant problem, because the cosmological constant problem is not a cosmological constant problem, it's a vacuum energy problem, which essential point is to know which particles and which is the mechanism generated that particles. But the explanation is by the fact that they are exactly mathematically and physically the classical quantum duals of each other, and is exactly this the value which is observed today refers to the same quantity which is attached to the vacuum of the early universe, Planckian or transplanckian. Is a very transplanckian value. It's a very transplanckian energy, and these two values are different because they refer to two different vacuum states. This is the nature of the vacuum, and the, this is the you can have many different vacuums, and the superficial interpretation would be to attach to the same vacuum what this. A different vacuum, a different eras, a different one is a very dualist and classical universe. The other is a very quantum transplanckian and high condense, high dense universe. And all. This is not for tweets. This is not pure chance. This is deep and robust because it came from some cornerstone. So this have more support in the. When we go to the computation of the gravitational entropy or connecting to the for the universe, which is a very important concept and connected to the vacuum energy. Gravitational entropy and the entropy and the gravitational temperature from that is just, and this appears from Euclidean gravity and many the years of Hawking, Gibbons, Bekenthe, and so on, and different computing of the internal degrees of freedom. I mean, but what it is a universal formula, which is the area over four. This is the Planck unit for the area with the length scale. This is the Planck area, and the unit for the entropy is P Boltzmann. So all the units are okay, and the temperature is the square root of that, which is a length or it is a mass. This is universal because when you are in the classical regime, you put the classical length, you put the classical area. When you are in the quantum regime, you use the same formula with the quantum length and with the quantum mass, and you obtain the Hawking temperature, you take all what it.
Norma, est-ce que tu peux conclure?
And the form, I mean, yes, and the formula I here saw for the entropy, that is a huge value, and we have from the quantum structure, so I have the quantum Lycon, which because of the Heisenberg principle, which give the classical Lycon, I mean, and the classical Lycon you will see, everybody knows as a straight lines, but these are just the asymptotic of hyperboloids which appear when you have the Heisenberg, or which is the particular is the 0 point energy. What this is, the you can compute then the classical, the the quantum levels. This region is the 0 point, which was left. I mean, in my last year, in one of my last year papers of the trilogy, in three dimension, and then here. So the classical Lycon, and which appear because is the just, and here we have the hyperboloids, and how this is how the picture extend with a whole regions, the future, the past, and you can describe also the black holes, I mean, or the complete completion, and these are the hyperboloids. And what I did this year is to describe this region here, which is the sitter or a vacuum energy. This is truly vacuum energy. And from that, from the quantum levels, discrete levels of space and time, say, of in some way, but you can compute for the entropy if you don't want to speak about time. So you extract for the two phases in the post-Planckian set phase of the universe, time bigger than Planck time, you have then for the cosmological constant or the vacuum energy, this to n, n is just the levels, the entropy is 2n plus 1, which gives in particular the mass or the entropy quantization for black holes, and the level for the Hubble constant. In the pre Planckian, we have with the Q here, we have the square root for H, and you have we have the square of that for lambda and for the entropy. And this is
Norma, can you conclude in 10 seconds?
And then we the universe start from the very a very excited level, which is given the values we know of lambda 10 powers 122 and very small entropy and minimal entropy, at least the minimal number we know today is this for the entropy, and goes exciting the levels, then goes at far the entropy goes on increasing the universe classicalize, increasing in these levels, we took the radius, increasing the time, in the time levels, as you have here, going to what is the previous of the CMD, the quantum precursor, which are near, I mean, before the Planck scale, and the quantum inflation, and going through the Planck scale, which is the n equal to zero, is the fundamental level for our universe, is the less excited level for the Transplanckian era, is nothing, it's just n equal zero, all magnitudes in Planck are in Planck units there, and then the universe continues its classicalization to the classical inflation, the level, the classical CMD, and all the levels we know till now, till the dark energy or reionization and so on, if we want to put in the different now with particle physics transition of a scale, you can go on and you can compute, so for all the levels. So this is a unifying picture which as I working on we have the different concepts which are now realized are the same concepts in its different gravity regimes.
Norma, on peut couper le son à un moment donné, donc il faudrait vraiment
okay,
que tu...
I start here, si. So just to stress that there is no singularity at the universe origin and is very concentrated, very highly excited de Sitter state. So, thank you.
Thanks a lot. Because we've exceeded the time by quite a few minutes, I suggest that people who want to ask questions to Norma do that privately and send emails or get in touch by Skype. So we should go on to the next speaker, who's Ziad now.